Today is Monday, June the 29th, 2020, and I'm pleased, very pleased, to welcome you to the seventh in our series of lessons on character training. This is a special character training program for doctoral students organized by the LASU Africa Center of Excellence for Innovative and Transformative STEM Education. We're doing this because we are producing the best PhDs for the African continent. I want them to be PhDs with character, because without character, that PhD is like nothing. Today, we are going to have a great leader in higher education in Africa, a great university administrator, a person with immense character. He's taking us with, he's going to be looking at four areas today, and he demonstrates as a person, because I've interacted with him over several years. Sincerity, he has it. Trustworthiness is trustworthy. Discipline is very disciplined. Accountability is accountable. So as you'll have noticed, we bring people who demonstrate these characters that we're asking them to demonstrate in their lives. We're going to move on to our lecture. We keep reminding ourselves that we are going to come out with great PhDs from our Center of Excellence and for University of Burundi. And you'll be expected to teach, to do research, and to do community service. I'll be measured on all of this. And without character, you are nowhere. You are nowhere to yourself. You are nowhere to anybody. You are useless to yourself. So what we are doing in this course is to support character building of PhD holders. And we keep reminding ourselves also that we cannot in 8 sessions get you all that you need to get in terms of career building. So what we're doing is to just do our best to put some seed in you for building character, and hoping that you keep reflecting on this over your service as a PhD holder to a university or to the community. Now, we're going to welcome our facilitator for today. He's Professor Ademola Tayo. He's the president / vice chancellor, Babcock University. But let's get to know a little bit about him. As I said, he's Ademola Tayo, professor and president / vice chancellor of one of Nigeria's greatest private universities. He's actually first generation private university, one of the earliest, to be established in Nigeria. Professor Ademola Tayo completed his PhD in development education at Central Luzon State University, Philippines, 1999. His academic work experience has been both within and outside Nigeria. He served as director of academic planning, special assistant to the vice chancellor of Babcock, visiting professor at the University of Eastern Africa, Barrington, Kenya, and interim president, Adventist University, Kosendai, Cameroon. Dean School of Postgraduate Studies, Babcock, in 2012, a position he held until 2015 when he was elected vice chancellor. He holds membership of many learned societies. He has been member of the accrediting team of International Board of Education, Silver Spring, Maryland, USA, to Adventist University of West Africa, Liberia, Valley View University, Ghana, Middle East University, Beirut, Lebanon, Samuk University, South Korea. Professor Ademola Tayo has widely traveled and has to his credit publications in peer-reviewed journals. He's a man who is very sincere. He's a man who is trustworthy. He's a man who is disciplined. And he's a man who ranks very high in accountability. So we want to hear him share his words of wisdom of sincerity, trustworthiness, discipline, and accountability as character attributes of a good PhD holder. Over to you, sir. president stroke vice chancellor.
Professor Peter Okebukola, a great mentor to many of us, myself inclusive. Also Emeritus Professor Nimi Briggs, my colleague, the Vice Chancellor of University of Doctoral Students. You should count yourself very lucky to belong to this group because of the international flavor and learning from great men. This morning, I want to share my thoughts with you on these very, very important four character attributes of doctoral students. I want to start by saying that the hallmark of a PhD holder is to make what is complex, what is idealistic, what is abstract, to be simple. I also believe that 1,000 words is inadequate to picture, or perhaps if I should go the other way around, a picture is more powerful and elucidates more than 1,000 words.
Correct.
Hence, I'm going to use pictures of animals to elucidate what I want to share with you this morning. Thereafter, I will try to draw live applications, real live applications, and I believe by God's grace, you'll be able to enjoy this discussion. I will share my screen right now. I want the host to please enable me to share my screen. Okay. Yeah, thank you very much. Now, attributes of a PhD holder. There you find four animals. And you may wonder, what does a leopard has to do with sincerity? A leopard is known for being very ferocious, aggressive. But in the course of this discussion, we'll be able to find out the sincerity of a leopard. Trustworthiness for a dog, for a bee, as well as accountability for ants. Let's move on to the next slide. The outline of my presentation, I'm going to start with a preamble, and then we take each of the character attributes one after the other. I want to start with a quote to continue this presentation. My first quotation is from the president of Russia, President Putin, and he said, "It is better to be hanged over loyalty than to be rewarded for betrayal." Dear doctoral students, you are going to be a PhD holder with a thrust that you cannot afford to betray. And the way that you can easily betray that trust is not to exemplify character attributes that we have been discussing over the last 3 weeks. I believe that Africa today have lots of academic giants, but are moral dwarfs. And I wish that we will learn from great men as we espouse these character attributes. The second quotation is, organizations, companies, or individuals without core values are exactly like a boat without an anchor. It can be easily tossed to and fro, following any direction the wind blows. And therefore, it's very, very important to have character attributes that will help you to be able to excel even after the doctoral training program. Preamble. Today, our world has witnessed a profound complexity and ambiguity in habits, practice and lifestyle among the highly educated to a level of asking on traditional questions around morality, person-specific characters. You see, we have seen science without conscience, wealth without work, business without morality, education without humanity. That is, I get that from a very great mind in our world. And of course, I had my own PhD without character. That expert is from Mahatma Gandhi, with PhD without character added. I need to be very, very, it's part of sincerity we are talking about today. When you get a quote, sincerity is to let the whole world knows that this is not mine. I got it from somewhere. The next slide talks about my experience. Having watched, managed, been a dean of the School of Postgraduate Studies, I want to infer that post-PhD life depends not only on intellectual brightness, but on moral principles, such as sincerity, trustworthiness, discipline, and accountability. I've seen great minds, professors, that have lost everything because of character flaw. And therefore, these attributes are interdependent and interwoven in construct and application, especially in the areas of moral judgment and ethical work life. A divorce of any leads to pervasiveness and cutting corners. The next slide, I will now go straight to sincerity. I wish we could have interaction, but if you look at the left side of the slide, you see an animal, a leopard, whiskers, and I'm afraid. How can one relate sincerity with a leopard? But when you look underneath, there's something there. It says, a leopard never changes his spots. Under no condition will a leopard change his, even when he's in danger. As against also another animal that we always blend the color to fit with the situation, and that is a condition. For having said this, sincerity is an academic life purged of deceit, pretense, hypocrisy, fraud, dishonesty, plagiarism. It is founded on strong work ethics and professionalism in exchange of idea and development of new knowledge. They are doctoral students. I wish to submit that we know in parts. Most often we wear masks. We pretend to be what we are not. After our PhD, we look invisible, all knowing because of PhD, always beside our names. But when you have gone through statistics, you have gone through great minds, and you see some mini specialties, micro specialties, the more you advance in knowledge, the more you know that you know little compared with all vast gamut of knowledge in the world today. Just like the Holy Scripture says, we know in part. God is able to have a total picture, is omniscient.
Sure.
And that will help you as you continue life after doctoral studies, to be able to have some words which should be with you every time, anywhere. I'm not sure. I will check. I'm wrong. You are right. I will let superior argument to take the day. Inferior argument will bow over superior argument.
Yeah.
You need to acknowledge sources when you write papers. You will not abrogate or take over an idea which is not your own. That's plagiarism. You will be quick to have collaboration with other people, knowing fully well that you know in part. And that is why today, the in thing is to have collaborations, multiple authors, because you know in part. Sincerity will push you to believe and to act, knowing fully well that you don't have the grasp of all the knowledge. Sincerity make you to acknowledge the data, the source of your data, and we allow you to use your data appropriately rather than to get use it to get at somebody or to do something that will not really make things work. To ensure that a PhD exhibits these attributes, the academic and philosophical issues in contemporary world and academic life, they are addressed at Babcock. Because at Babcock, ontological issues drive the research work in terms we see academic insincerity. As I speak with you today, the university invested so much on Tony.com, so much so that in Babcock University today, you cannot graduate either at the undergraduate level or at the postgraduate level without feeding your project or your thesis, your dissertation into the dotting software, so that you'll be able to look at the similarity index, look at the threshold, and the Senate of the university are taking action that for any PhD student to graduate from Babcock, there must be a certification from Office of Institutional Effectiveness to show that the threshold of the similarity index do not exceed what is said by the University Senate. For a PhD holder, after your project is fed into the software, turning.com, the similarity index must not go beyond 10%. For masters, it's 15%. For undergraduate, 20%. This is to ensure that we do not have many of the work that has been done here be a product of plagiarism. I have two gentlemen on the screen, which I pray that you will not also be. One of them is Erin Potts-Kant of Duke University. Time will not allow me to speak so much about, but it cost Duke University in the US paying over $100 million to NIH and the granting organizations because of plagiarism. The same thing, Cho Cook's daughter, who was to apply to a medical school, and they used the name of the daughter as the first author. The same thing, Stephen Jackson in University of Bristol in UK. All of these came about because of data falsification and data fabrication. Sincerity will allow you as doctoral students, even after you are done, when you are doing your research, not to use data or manipulate data in order to be able to get your way. Zimbabwe University exposes students to training in statistical software because we believe so much in hands-on experience. Virtually all our programs have laboratory. We have economics laboratory. We have even language laboratory, so that there will be hands-on experience, so much so that by the time you are out your postdoctoral, you will be able to do your work without subletting this thing to people that will manipulate figures for you, because at the end of the day, you'll be accountable to what is out. As a matter of fact, we have to discipline some students because of plagiarism. The next point is trustworthiness. I think this is something which we all agree with, that among domestic animals in the world today, the dog has been the most faithful and trustworthy animal. We have had situations whereby at the cost of the life of dogs, they have to go into water and bring out babies that are drowning. We've seen dogs going into where there are fire outbreak, going in to rescue the owner. We have seen them attacking snakes and so many other in order to be able to. Dogs is a trustworthy animal. And in Babcock University, our word is our bond. That's a quotation. My character is my collateral. They are all engraved statements of commitment.
Wow.
Our university, because we believe that this act is to ensure internalization of integrity, reliability, and honesty in life. And that is why the era of turning software came about, because of academic dishonesty. Over the years, Babcock decided to allow biblical and science pillared on empiricism and logical reasoning to permit the person-specific character in order to build trust. Trust is not about intellectual and technical competence. It is confidence in someone's character. So, ladies and gentlemen, I wish to say this morning that it's very, very important that we are trustworthy because we are gatekeepers of knowledge.
Sure.
We manage facts and figures, and we must be able to have unbiased dispensation of knowledge. For example, as I speak to you this morning, we have one of our PhD students who is the Accountant General of Lagos State. Despite the fact that he was doing the PhD on a part-time basis, he will be the first person to be in the class.
Mm.
And he worked conscientiously so much so that God honored him by making him to be the Accountant General of Lagos State right now. We also have Okonjo Iweala, which after leaving the office, she had so many appointments because of her fidelity, because of her trustworthiness when she was the Minister of Finance for the country. Babcock University deliberately, in building character, we do cooperation and co-creation of ideas, democratic, participative and collaborative research and conference activities. That is what we do in order to ensure that our students are trustworthy. The next one is discipline. You will all agree with me. Reason why B is called BCB. Have you ever thought about the reason why that adjective used to call B? B is always busy, always disciplined, self-regulatory, self-control, self-imposed mandatory rules and personal choices to ensure discipline-driven life. A B, either in the morning, in the evening, in the night, will be focused on the assignment, looking for flowers to suck the nectar to discharge the activity. And that is why it's called B. A disciplined person will have respect for time and days of appointments. And I want to say this is where Professor Peter Okebukola, I give a thumb to him. I've had opportunity to interact with him severally at Abeokuta, in Obasanjo Library. It's 9 o'clock.
Hmm?
Appointments. You see, respect for scholastic audience, respect for inter and intradisciplinary discourse, meeting deadlines and preventing procrastination. I wish to say that discipline is self-mastery. Alexander the Great did great of exploits, but he died prematurely because of lack of discipline. And therefore, doctoral students, we need to learn how to abstain from things that will derail us from achieving our goals. There are some things which could derail, and that is one of them is time management. Today we have a lot of social media which waste people's time and will not allow one to be able to reach one's goal, like Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, WhatsApp. That one should fast from all those things that may not make one to be able to reach one's goal. Even eating and drinking, rest, balanced living. People used to tell me, you are slim, you look frail. But how come that when it comes to exercise, you are always there almost every morning? This morning I've been out because I believe that I need to master myself. I need to be able to maintain my weight. I need to maintain good health because of the pressure associated with this office that I occupy. And therefore, discipline, even in what we eat. Many a times we eat fats at the age we are, and then we are obese. We have a lot of health issues. That needs to be very much taken into consideration as we talk about discipline. You see, as I said earlier on, we have so many academic giants, but moral dwarf because of the inability to be able to discipline oneself. For example, Discipline helps to ensure that one is prevented from drift and rift, which may eventually lead to misunderstanding and conflict. Therefore, Babcock University, I say, one of the things that have been helping Babcock over the last 20 years is our discipline, particularly when it comes to time. For the last 20 years, the day of our graduation is cast in iron. On the first Sunday of June every year, 10 o'clock, not 10:01, 10 o'clock on the dot, graduation will set in, except this year because of the corona pandemic. And to mark that day, there was a video on YouTube where we were able to tell the whole world to congratulate our students that we are celebrating them, though we ought to be on the stadium now to celebrate you, but because of the pandemic. So management of time, academic supervision as precondition for admission. We have student handbook intended to shape character, build resilience, and focus. The interpretation and implementation of these rules are for the transformation of lives and modeling of others towards a better society. So what I'm trying to emphasize there, colleagues, is the fact that discipline will allow us to be able to guide again, being moved up and down because of the fact that we are not able to manage ourselves. So self-mastery is discipline. And this is very, very important post-PhD. Now, the next one is accountability. Wow, an ant. You may wonder, what is it that qualifies an ant to be accountable? You will see from that picture some ants at the bottom, some each of the ants do have their role, and they with fidelity follow their role. Each one is accountable to the other. We have the soldiers, we have the king, we have the queen, all of them accountable to one another. And that is why ants can do what even a giant, a Goliath cannot do, because they are accountable to each other. They follow details, instruction. They are transparent with one another, and they do their obligation as at when due. So accountability is a moral of every pre-PhD holder to oneself and others. The ant who is a worker has an obligation to the king. The king has obligation to the queen. The queen has obligation to the soldiers in the ant's kingdom. So is the ability to hold oneself accountable to the other person, to accept responsibility and to disclose academic facts, data, and results in a transparent manner. A moral judge of human act, so that my words and conduct have universal principles. I wish to say that we are responsible to God first and foremost, irrespective of our religion. We are responsible to ourselves. We are responsible to our institutions. We are responsible even to our family members. And therefore, I always advocate that every student, and I want to recommend it to all doctoral students, you must have accountability partners. I will use my example as a vice chancellor. Vice chancellor could be somehow invisible. And it dawned on me right from the beginning on 1st of December 2015 that power corrupts and absolute power corrupts absolutely. So the first thing I did was to strengthen the internal unit. There is a link, a dotted link to the government. I so much empowered the internal auditors to be my accountability partner, so that any receipt, anything that needs to be done from the VC's office, if you are using, you are taking 5 minutes to use that for the others, use 10 minutes and make sure that everything is done properly. The procurement unit of the university, in such a way that it must be done in a very transparent manner. I insisted on approval limits, that even the vice chancellor must have approval limits for money, and that must be stuck to. Because when the leader sets a limit, others will follow. And so as a PhD holder, you are a mini maker, and the whole world will look at you as leaders. You must be able to win yourself from things that may make you to have power so much so that you are not accountable to anybody. You see, for example...
Yeah, two more minutes.
Okay, I always tell graduates, your is given to you. But remember, the certificate can be withdrawn. And therefore, you must do everything possible to ensure that even after leaving the four walls of the university, you hold yourself accountable to the institution that gave the diploma. So also our PhD holders, when you leave Lagos State University, you are still accountable and you'll be held responsible. Ladies and gentlemen, in research grants, there are a lot of misrepresentation of facts, cheating, plagiarism, receipt falsification, which are all things that are not to be had among PhD holders. And so since you are going to go for grants, always remember it is very, very important to do what is right because you are accountable. Final note, I wish to say we have the Office of Research, Innovation, and International Cooperation. And they are saddled with watching and monitoring to make sure that our researches bear what is very good, what is the things that one can be proud of. Research accountability, research integrity will be the hallmark of the university. In closing, I've shared my thoughts, my experiences. As I draw on these life experiences, my cross this morning is that people should define, judge, and evaluate you by your character consistency. And that same should transform the next generation for a better society. Once again, it is better to be hanged for loyalty than to be betrayed, than to be rewarded for betrayal. Thank you very much for listening.
Oh, wonderful. I do not know how to thank Professor Ademola Tayo, President, for this very wonderful lecture. We got feedback from students. Ramadan from Burundi did express our mind by saying that this is a very great lecture, very great indeed. We'd like to thank Professor Tayo for the we'd like to thank him for this very clear lecture, and it is now time to invite us all to give a round of applause for a start to Professor Tayo for a job very well done. Thank you so very much. Even our great Vice Chancellor, University of Ibadan, said it's an extraordinary lecture. Very clear, lucidly delivered with good examples from himself and from his university. What I think we'd like to do now, we have 7 minutes to close this, actually 10 minutes to close this. I'm going to ask Professor Gbamanja from Sierra Leone to make just 1 minute comment on this. I'm going to ask Professor Briggs, I'm going to ask Professor Layinka, Professor Uchizewi, just 1 minute share your comments on these four key character attributes that Professor Ademola Tayo has very explicitly presented to us. So if Professor Chinzewi, I'm going in reverse order. Professor Chinzewi, if you can just unmute your microphone and share your experience with us.
Thank you so very much. I am particularly happy about what's the accountability aspect. Make sure you have an accountability partner. It keeps you in check. And from my personal experience, from the time I now started letting some other person tell me, Uche, no, you've done, you are not getting it right, I tend to be on the right path. So accountability is important if you have an accountability partner. Thank you very much.
Hey, wonderful. Thank you very much. Professor Uche Nanziwe, we'll go on to our Vice Chancellor, Investor of Badon, Professor Eduola Inka.
Thank you, sir. I just comment on one of the subsections of the brilliant talk by Professor Tayo. I mean, in terms of trustworthiness, I think it's good for people to be very consistent. I think I alluded to that severally in the talk. People should be able to know that on this particular issue, this is where Professor Kubukola will stand. Not that people cannot predict you. I think it's really very important that you are trustworthy. On a particular issue, I can say this is the way Professor Nimi Brice would have handled it because of what they can say of him over the years. And if you did ask Professor Nimi Brice, exactly that's what he would have said. I think it's very important that you should be trustworthy, not that you are so unpredictable. And because he said that the leopard will never change its spots. So that is your nature, and you don't have any apologies. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so very much, sir. Our Vice Chancellor, Investor of Badon, is saying, don't be a chameleon. When you are in an environment, you just change because you don't want to hurt people. You go to another environment, you change because you don't want to hurt people. So let stand for what you know is right and let people know where you stand on matters. So we have used Professor Nimi Briggs as an example. So let's go on to Professor Nimi Briggs. Grandpa Briggs. So what do you say?
Mr. Chairman, my dear friends and colleagues, what else does one say? You know, I keep making the point that I am the one learning a lot from this program. And I really envy my colleagues, the students. You have had a wonderful, you are having a wonderful time. These issues that have been raised consistently, these are the issues that enable you to develop a character in academia that people respect. And it is very important that in academia you are able to do that. Because when you come out now and then you join one university or what have you, or whatever, there will be many of you. People will begin to categorize you. They will begin to define you by what you do. And the things that you do that enable you get defined in a proper manner are these issues that are being raised consistently. Look at the statements that were made, the authoritative statements that were made about Peter Kebukola. I got to know this young man, you know, several years back. That was in 2003.
No, 2001, sir. 2001.
Yeah. Okay. From that date till today, the man has not changed. And this is what we want in academia. This is what we want in academia. When you do that, it will play out in the statistics you publish, in the papers you publish and all that. Academia is looking for people like that. And I'm glad that these things are being placed before us over and over again. And I thank Tayo very, very exceedingly for the wonderful lecture. I'm very grateful indeed. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Grandpa Professor Nimi Briggs. We are super delighted. Since 2001 that I met Professor Nimi Briggs. Professor Nimi Briggs was Vice Chancellor, University of Port Harcourt, and he led that university solidly. Now, the next person I'm going to call is also somebody who served dutifully in the University of Port Harcourt. But before calling him, you can always predict Professor Nimi Briggs. Professor Nimi Briggs knows that while we met, I was a general secretary, National Universities Commission. When we say VCs, we are meeting that meeting at 9 a.m. or 10 a.m. Professor Briggs knows. I'll be there before. God help you if you are late for my meeting. And then secondly, Professor Briggs is somebody who is so, I will always know what Professor Briggs is going to say about a matter. Because it's somebody who is going to tell you objectively, is not going to be contextualizing his views based on who is there at that particular time. He's very clear-headed and clear-minded. And these are some other attributes we want our PhD holders, you know, to grab the thing. So Professor Nimi Briggs, when you give him an assignment, he's the first, in spite of his age, you know, although he's just 42 years old, and I'm just 42. So, oh. In spite of his age, he brings the first to submit, he's the first to the crop. Actually, all the words we are using today are for Nimi Briggs. Disciplined, sincere, trustworthy, and highly accountable. Now, over to Professor Sir Piti Gbamanja from Sierra Leone. Over to you, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I'm always grateful to Professor Nimi Briggs because it was during his tenure that I became a professor. And I was told that during the decision-making, one word he used, he said, Dr. Gbamanja is very humble. And that was one of the reasons why everybody, in fact, my professorship was awarded and confirmed by everybody in Senate. Professor Briggs, I know, can confirm that because he was the chairman there. But having said that, I think these are the lectures that make Peter, Professor Kebukla, justified when he said that we have the best PhDs in Africa. I'm not sure such lectures are given in any university. I've talked in many universities at the doctoral level, but lectures on character development, this is the first time I'm listening to a lecture on that. And the truth is that we give lecture, I mean, when we are giving degrees, we say we're giving you this degree in character and learning, but nobody pursues this. I'm happy I'm pro-chancellor of a Catholic university where, I mean, all these things are taught, religion is taught, and the morality is practiced. So I would like to say, in addition to my fellow professor who gave this lecture, that these things are even more practiced in private universities than
in public universities.
Correct. Because in private universities, we can handle our students better. We can threaten them better. We can bring them up through humility. So I think that this is a lecture not only for doctoral students, but for everybody in the university.
Indeed,
we have the best doctoral students in Africa, I think this lecture is very, very, very important. And I do hope that they will practice it when they leave. Thank you so much.
Thank you so very much, sir, Professor Sir Piti Gbamanja. And I would like to yield to Professor Ademola Tayo, if we have just 1 minute, if there are some closing thoughts that you would like to share with us. Over to you, Professor Ademola Tayo. President, Your Excellency, President of Babcock University, GCFR.
Thank you very much, my mentor, to our PhD holders. It's very, very important that you are trustworthy. You should bear in mind that if no one sees you, God is looking at you.
Oh, yes.
Do exercise caution in everything you do. PhD, people will look at you and we give you respect, but that must not be abused. Let us always remember that we are accountable to God. We are accountable to our family. We are accountable even to the institution that gave us the PhD. And therefore, we do everything we need to do in the honor of God and to the glory of mankind. Before I close, we had to expel one of our students because of this sex video. And people cried out that, well, it was done outside the campus. But we told them that, well, the issue, reputational damage, brand damage, so long as the name is linked with Babcock, even post-institution, you still have to conduct yourself in the way and the manner that is worthy of the school where you graduated from. And therefore, I want to leave our doctoral student with the idea that always be truthful, always be trustworthy, always be accountable, always be sincere. And the Lord will bless you abundantly. Thank you very much
Amen.
For this.
Amen. Wonderful. Wonderful way to close this. Wonderful way. We can see everybody's clapping for you, sir.
Yes.
And we are deeply, deeply appreciative of what you have just shared with us. So from our little end here, sir, we want to appreciate you. And I would like to call on Modina Togundele, if you can unmute yourself, can you present this appreciation plaque on our behalf to President Professor Ademola Tayo.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir, for the opportunity, sir. Thank you. Really appreciate the lecture, sir. On behalf of Lagos State University, African Center of Excellence for Innovative and Transformative STEM Education, a World Bank project, this is to certify that Professor Ademola Tayo facilitated the character training program for doctoral students in Africa, June-July 2020, signed by distinguished Professor Peter Okebukola, who is our director. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so very much. Again, let's give a round of applause to Professor Ademola Tayo, President/Vice-Chancellor, Babcock University. So we can see messages coming in. We love you, sir. Thank you so much for a brilliant lecture. So, dear students, dear facilitators, until tomorrow, when we have another in the series, the last but one, from the Vice Chancellor of the University of Ibadan, Nigeria's premier university, Professor Abel Idowu Olayinka. It is bye for now.